Hello and welcome everybody to Synthetic Opinion, the Life Science Podcast. This is Linus, and today we are talking about scientific careers outside of the laboratory. It is widely known that not all who study life science, be it biochemistry, biotechnology or something else, end up working in an actual lab. But after this notion, it usually becomes pretty vague. What exactly are these other jobs that are so often hinted at? Today I'm talking with Christiane Luley, a scientific project manager at the Austrian Center of Biotechnology, in short ACIB, a non-profit research institution and networking enabler. She will give us some insight into her own scientific career that eventually led her outside of the laboratory and into project management. Welcome, Christiane.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
Christiane, can you tell us about what exactly is your current position?
So I'm working at the Austrian Center of Industrial Biotechnology, and I started to work there as a scientist. It's in 2010, so it's quite some time ago already. And within ACIB, it's depending on the size of the projects what position you're in. So I started as a scientist working with others who were managing the project, but then rather quickly, I think after 1 year, we started a small project where I was scientist and project manager all in the same person already right away. So now at the moment my bench work is limited or does not exist at all, so I'm now completely into project managing, but still doing a lot of scientific discussions with the group of people working in the projects.
Oh, well, so this means your transition out of the laboratory and into management was quite smoothly, with an actually perfectly in-between job where you did both of these jobs.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, so when I finished my PhD, I did 1 year of a postdoc, a fellow at the Institute of Biotechnology and Biochemical Engineering. And by that time, I was already looking for something where the enzymes I was working with are applied in industrial processes. So that's why ACIB turned out to be the perfect research organization for me. So it's not ACIB is, as you said before, an international competence center, but it's not doing only basic research. We are linking the gap between academic research and industry. So when I started to work at ACIB, it was clear from the beginning that the projects are all more industry related. So normally in a company project, you have one or two company partners that are interested in the same topic. And then you as a scientist work on the different scientific tasks and develop the project further. Yeah. So that was what fascinated me. Yeah. So the as I mentioned before, the class of enzymes that I'm still working with, that are carbohydrate active enzymes, I was already working with in my PhD. And so it went really smoothly to now transfer the enzymes to industrial production processes.
You were mentioning ACIB is a competence center. I think most people know or have a picture of what an industrial institution is or what an academic institution like a university is. But what is a competence center exactly?
Yeah, so ACIB calls itself an international competence center. And as I mentioned, we are bridging the gap between academic research and the producing industries. Yeah, so we have our scientists working at academic institutions. We can make use of the academic infrastructure and also of the know-how of the scientists who have the basic knowledge. And on the other hand, we have our industry partners that bring in the environmental or economic, let's call it economic aspects. Yeah. So what scientists do when they are in basic or in academic research, we work on very basic topics. So like characterization of enzymes, understanding their molecular mechanism, engineering the enzymes to do something else what they did not do before. But when it comes to application of these enzymes in industrial processes, we need the input from the industry partners. So we need their interest in using our enzymes. And this is what ACIB does. That the center brings together the scientists and the industrial partners. And we are aiming to develop environmentally friendly and economically viable biotechnological production processes.
Ah, that's very interesting. So a competence center is actually really in the middle field of an academic and an industrial institution, because it's particularly aiming at having both sides of the coin within the same research topic on the same research project.
Yeah, and what is also always highlighted is that ACIB somehow forms a hub where academic scientists and industry come together, and ACIB makes it easier for the industry to cooperate with academia, because sometimes they are contract regulations, the IP regulations. This is all quite complicated when you want to work directly with universities. And ACIB has developed an expertise in between to make all this formal administrative work or contract work easier.
Yeah, this sounds actually very useful. I have, in fact, my own experience where an industrial partner went to a lab where I was working in. And from a scientific standpoint, we were very interested in each other, but we could not make the IP, the patent regulations, work, because the university had some very strict regulations themselves for financing from industry, and these were too strict and therefore not interesting for the industrial partners anymore. Mm-hmm. So maybe in this case, something like ACIB can be extremely helpful. Well, so you basically left the laboratory work of science. Was it a conscious decision to find a job outside the lab, or did you just follow the opportunities as they came in?
Yeah, it was also, I think, a development of my personal career. It happened, as I mentioned before, that we had this one project where I was a scientist and project manager all in one person. And I was doing all the lab work myself and managing. But shortly after that, we also had an EU, and it was an FP7 project by that time, started. And there, my lab work, I changed actually the bench to more the administrational work in the office, yeah. And I think also my... because by that time I also went on maternity leave for the first time. And when I came back, it was of course much easier to work in the office instead of working in the lab. Because how can you design an experiment to really finish by noon when you have to go home and pick up your kid from the kindergarten?
Yeah, I see. Office work is just much more flexible, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And... that was maybe the time, so when I came back after maternity leave, that I sticked with project management work a lot. I was still doing small scientific experiments, but it somehow always changed more into the managing activities. And it was good for my family situation, because you can also sometimes, if necessary, if you have deadlines, work from home, because if your computer is your working station, you can do it from everywhere. And
yeah, that's right. So this means your transition from science into the project management was driven also mostly by practical reasons and practical considerations.
That's true, yeah.
Well, do you then miss maybe something from your laboratory work that you don't have now anymore?
I do miss it sometimes, but as I'm not completely, so still I'm discussing with the team of people working in the lab on a weekly basis. So I'm not there by myself in the lab, but I'm up to date what is going on there. So we discuss in detail single experiments, and I provide them with suggestions, or we together think about new strategies of how to tackle the problem. So this is what makes me not really miss the experimental work a lot, because I'm in my thoughts, so in my head, I'm still there. Yeah? Mm-hmm. I'm just not doing it by myself. And when my PhD students tell me that the HPLC is making troubles, I'm actually quite happy that I'm not the one who has to deal with these problems. I'm just telling them, okay, then let's analyze the samples again and let's discuss maybe in a few days. So this is all a positive.
I see, but
aspect.
You don't have to tackle all these tiny itty-bitty problems from practical everyday lab work, yeah. Right? Can you maybe explain to us what is your everyday work then as a project manager?
Yeah, maybe I can refer to the Carbofin project here, because this is the Horizon 2020 project, which was granted now almost 2 years ago. And it's the first project that ACIB is coordinating. So we are now really in doing active management within Carbofin. And here I'm my daily work looks like that Carbofin consists of the Carbofin consortium has 8 partners. So I'm communicating with the partners a lot. I'm communicating with our project officer. I have to take care that the project progress happens in time, yeah, so that deliverables are written and submitted in time. Let's say that the group of people from ACIB working in Carbofin is rather big. So we have 2 PhD students, 1 other scientist, a technician, and 1 person who is assisting in dissemination activities. So we are meeting on a weekly basis. So we're sitting together, discussing scientific results, discussing how to go on, what to do next. In the end, it's like managing of a project is being on the phone a lot, or writing emails, writing reports. So I enjoy it very much that I'm still scientifically involved in the discussions with the PhD and the scientists here at ACIB.
I think it's very interesting for many people to know that there are actually science-involved jobs that are not strictly purely academic. It sounds now like you're doing a lot of course, this coordinating work, maybe sometimes paperwork and stuff like this, but you're still a scientific advisor in a way, very much involved into the actual science of the topics.
I think managing of a project like Carbofin, yeah, maybe if you do not have a scientific background, it is really difficult because you have to have a good overview of the overall goal of Carbofin, and you have to know how the individual work package interact with each other, and you have to bring the scientists together to talk with each other, and sometimes even maybe translate the science to the industry partners. Mm-hmm. That's why I think having a scientific background on this class of enzymes, because Carbofin is dealing with carbohydrate active enzymes, makes it a lot easier.
If you were to describe it, how does a good working day look like in comparison to a bad working day as a project manager?
So I'm lucky that at ACIB I have a team that is taking over the financial reporting, because this is something which you have to really focus on and you have to understand, and it's completely different from scientific work and from being in contact with the partners. So there, how to do financial reporting, yeah, that is something which sometimes causes me headaches. Yeah? So
maybe because it also has to be extremely precise and correct in every way, right?
Yeah, so there are a lot of Horizon 2020 rules out there that help you in reporting your financials. And if you're into it, it's easy. And that's why I'm happy that we have the team at ACIB, the management team, who is taking over this duty. And they are also communicating with the other partners who also need some help to prepare their financial statements. So this, we just had to submit our month 18 report in summer. So that was a busy time. I would not call it a bad day, but it was busy. Yeah. So, And what else sometimes is difficult is when you communicate that when there is some task appearing or some problem, but there is something which you have to discuss with different people. And if you cannot discuss it with them all together because of time reasons or of because they are not here at the same location, and you have to talk to them all individually, it makes all the things very complicated, because when you talk with one partner and then you have to transfer the information to the other partner, and then you get some questions back, but you don't know because you did not talk with the other partner about that. So it's going in circles. Yeah, so going in circles, this is something which I really don't like. So I prefer to organize phone calls with all of them together, and maybe even better to meet face to face.
Yeah, sounds very nice. What kind of person do you think fits very well into project management jobs?
Yeah, so if them, like in my case, I knew quite early, so I think already during my master's, that carbohydrate active enzymes are really an interesting class of enzymes, and there is future potential for them to be applied in industrial processes. So looking back at my education, I could not have done better, because what I'm doing now in Carbofin is managing a project that deals with this class of enzymes. But still, I think that I'm also able to manage other biotechnological projects, because I have the scientific understanding of how enzymes work. Yeah. However, I think it is not absolutely necessary, because if you are only managing the project, you have the description of action, the DOA, and you have to take care that everything is delivered on time, and that you can easily do. But what I have not mentioned so far is that within ACIB, of course, the projects are maybe 1 or 2 or at the maximum 4 years long, so you also have to do project acquisition. And how can you do project acquisition if you do not know the background? So you, that's why, I think the development of your career does maybe always include, if you're not going for an academic career, that you start as a scientist and you turn into a manager and into project leader maybe even. And you always have to find or to acquire new projects so that
that the money comes, keeps coming.
Yeah. And this is maybe concerning the scientific career. But on the other hand, what I also enjoy a lot is that during my managing activities, I also developed my soft skills a lot. So how do I have to communicate with my scientific partners? How do I have to communicate with industry? It's different. And you, maybe in a seminar, you are told that it's different, but you can only practice, or you can only really learn it from practicing it.
So would you say that project management is mostly for people who are also communicative, or at least interested and talking to a lot of different people?
Yeah, to being, I think it is beneficial. If if you like to communicate with others, and if you find the right words, how to communicate that. Mm-hmm. What else I think is important is that if you have some writing skills, because you have to write reports, deliverables quite a lot, also organizing, for example, workshops or meetings is something if you like to communicate with people, much easier.
Yeah, I can imagine. So a project manager communicates a lot in written or verbal form, but communication is your everyday work, basically.
Yeah, that's true, yeah. And what I also learned during managing of Carbofin is that sometimes it's even easier to call people and to talk to them on the phone, but still it's good to have it in written form afterwards so that you can recall it easier.
Yeah, I can imagine, especially when you're talking with several people, you just need something like a protocol or some agreed upon document about what has been said and what were the most important talking points. So, and that's it already. Thank you, Christiane, for talking to us today and for giving us insight into the life of a scientific project manager.
Yeah, thanks for giving me the opportunity to talk to you.